Hi, I'm going to show you how to shoot a 360 panorama using a regular camera and a regular lens and a tripod. This is not the ideal setup. Ideally, you would have a panoramic tripod head, which allows you to rotate the lens around a certain axis. Here we don't have that, but maybe this is all you've got, so this is how we're going to do it. Now, you should have your camera in portrait vertical orientation, not horizontal landscape orientation. This will give you more vertical space in the final panorama. If you have it this way, the panorama will be really skinny. Now, to prepare for shooting, you have to figure out how many shots that you need to take in a circle. Or you can look through the lens each time, and when you turn the camera, make sure that there's some overlap. The pictures should overlap 30% to 50%. They shouldn't overlap too much and they shouldn't overlap too little. If they're just barely touching, they probably won't be able to fit together later. So I'm going to shoot, I think it's about 18 pictures in a circle. It sounds like a lot, but it's pretty fast. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, that's it. That's a 360 panorama using a regular camera and regular lens. If you are interested in shooting it more seriously, then you can get better equipment, but this is all you've got. It works fine. Now, I'll upload these pictures to panomonkey.com. They'll be stitched into a 360 degree panorama automatically. For the exposure, it's best if you keep the same exposure and white balance for each picture. You can have it in automatic if you want, but it won't turn out quite as nicely. There will be variations in different parts of the panorama. If you don't feel comfortable doing the manual exposure yourself, that's fine. Do an automatic exposure, no problem. So that's all. Happy shooting. Have fun.